Accelerator is a double face machine. On one side is a super microscope.
We can look at the detail of the infinitely small. But by looking at that, in reality, we're going to be able to answer questions about the universe or something infinitely big.
The final purpose of an accelerator is basically to discover how we are made.
We want to know who we are, we want to know where we're coming from. I think it's connected to human nature.
Where does the mass come from? And very many fundamental questions, the origin of the universe and so on and so forth, which we are trying to understand with the LHC.
We know that Higgs boson, we have proven that the Higgs boson exists.
The mass explained by the Higgs boson is only 5% of the universe. We know much more than our father, but we have much more questions than our father. Knowledge must go on.
We want to increase the luminosity of the machine.
We want to increase the rate at which we produce physics. And that's the upgrade of the Large Hadron Collider.
Well, the plan is, first of all, to run the LHC for about 10 years, and then to do a big step. And this big step is called high luminosity LHC.
So the purpose of the iLumi LHC is actually to increase the number of collisions.
Two colliding beams, these are proton beams.
The beam is like a train, and you have to imagine that this train has 2,808 bunches.
The beam goes very fast, goes at the speed of the light.
Each bunch is a wagon, and in each wagon you have 120,000 million of protons.
It passes in front of me in 1 billionth of a second. 1 billionth of a second, no time to look at it.
Basically, if this cloud is smaller, more compressed, we increase the probability of having collision between these two clouds.
And this basically means increase possibility for new discoveries.
I'd like to be in this room, and instead to be illuminated by a bulb of 100 watts, very suddenly you turn on a bulb of 1,000 watts, 1 kilowatt. You have a lot of light. You see much better.
More collision means more discovery.
It is probably the largest scientific instrument and the most complex scientific instrument ever conceived.
You need to generate very low temperatures.
So we go cooler than the universe. It's a fantastic adventure to the cold world.
We need a new type of superconductor material, which is niobium-13.
Even in applications like high voltage cables, you never transfer more than about 2,000 amps. Here are 20,000, so 10 times more.
We are making magnetic fields that are a bit less than a half a million larger than the magnetic field of the Earth.
This is one of the new types of magnets for the high luminosity LHC project.
We are joining a beautiful adventure of science. Not only science, it's also a human adventure.
In the society today, we are getting more and more focused on the short term. At CERN, we are making an investment on long term. So it's like the cathedral of middle age, that people start and then the song continues and then the grand song. We can work together also, not only across borders, but also across time.
Of course, you're always afraid, you know, something may fail. I may not make it, but that's actually why we are trying to do that. We're pushing those boundaries.
We are all here to answer to a fundamental question that we have in ourselves. The question for more, what we are made of, where we come from.
It's important to have a tool like this because it will allow us to see things that up to now we have not seen.
We are like the people that are building up the ship with which Christophorus Columbus will discover America. No ships, no new land.